Bienvenidos and welcome, señores and señoritas, to this episode of Lifestyles of the Good, the Bad, and the Feo, or Ugly, with me, Fernando Vega III. In today's episode, we will explore the myth of Desert Ray's oddity of a man known as Dade Wildchild. Now, story goes, he was raised by natives after his family was killed off by wolves. For whatever reason, the wolves let the young boy leave. When he was found, his face was covered in blood, and a dead wolf lay nearby. He has una cicatriz en la cara, a scar on his face. Unsure as to how exactly he got the scar, the ones that found him surveyed the area and came to a conclusion. They believe he and the wolf fought, and clearly the wolf did not make it. I mean, could you imagine? There you are, a wee child, no older than 5, facing down an apex predator, the likes of which few men could have overcame. Madre de Dios, my skin crawls just thinking about it. Nonetheless, he made it, and that lobo didn't. Mira, he learned broken English and the tongue of his adopted people. He liked their language better than English, which he found obnoxious. And I get it though, hard language to comprehend and to duplicate, but that's neither here nor there, right? We are here to discuss this loco hombre. So Dade distanced himself from most folks outside a few amigos that were just as crazy as he was. Now, I keep saying crazy, cause this vato, he had no fear. And was a genuine good guy. And he treated his horse, which he named Mato, meaning bear, better than most people. When asked why he chose the name, it was because when he called for his horse, those that knew the meaning would run, thinking a bear was coming. Like I said, crazy Mato. He hated how folks treated each other, so he chose to stay away. I mean, his people even moved south of the border just because they couldn't deal with it anymore. Now, with the new world growing, more and more people moved out to the desert. His curiosity started to get the better of him, so he began to explore beyond Chola Springs and into Hennigan State and beyond. Now this first story about Wildchild takes us to McFarland Ranch. He was running through the hills when he saw smoke from the main house and wandered onto the property. He was muy curious. He needed to know what's going on. And he was greeted by everyone he ran across and appreciated their friendliness. He was asked to see Maggie on the porch about helping out. Being curious man he was, he eagerly went to see her. She, however, was caught up in her thoughts.
Oh, please don't tell me.
Let's join them. See how it goes.
Were you just looking for work? Can I help you? Oh, please don't tell me you've come a robin. I haven't got the time. Were you just looking for work? We're trying to get packed up. My father wants to go on a trip, avoid the illness that's plaguing the county. He's never run away from anything in his life. At least that's the way he tells it. Now this. Mabel, please pack all my dresses and both the guns.
Yes, Miss McFarland.
Sweet girl. The village idiot can be unkind to most idiots.
Miss McFarland?
Yes, Amos?
The wagon. It's gone.
Gone where, precisely?
Well, we don't know. That's what gone means. It means that you cannot find it.
Well, actually, on point of order, it doesn't, but let's not get lost in semantics. Any clue as to where it might be?
I suppose. Maybe Jimmy used it to take his mother to the doctor. He's riding through some nasty country.
God damn it. Excuse me. Amos, get on with the milking.
Yes, Miss McFarland.
You wouldn't mind trying to find this damn wagon, would you? I'll pay you handsomely. We're very short-handed right now. Thank you.
Whoa, some intense conversation for sure. But needless to say, I'm happy to report that he was able to fulfill that mission successfully. He went and got that cart, but unfortunately, the passengers, they did not make it. No, la muerte, they did not make it.
Beat 10 buttons, beat 10 buttons, beat 10 buttons.